Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope all of you will be fine. Okay, we have got our science of class prep, and what we are going to do, we are going to open page number 7. Dear students, as you know that we have done the reading of our senses, the unit number 2, and we have learned the questions, the 3 question answers from our Urdu workbook planning. Okay, and we have done this activity as well. So next we have got another very interesting activity. Here we have got different animals and a man, and here their noses are mentioned. So we have to basically match them, we have to join them. Okay, that which animal or human have got nose like these. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to have a scale. Okay, you have to put the date over here as well. So put the date on this page. So first of all, we have got a human. Okay, a human here. So check in this list where we can find a human nose. Okay, let me clear it for you. Here, can you see where is the human nose? Yes, right here we have got the human nose. So what we are going to do, we are going to join these two. Okay, we will take a scale and draw a straight line. Okay, next we have got what? A horse. As you can see, we have got a horse here. So find out where the nose of a horse. Here we have, yes, we can find a horse nose here. So we are going to place the scale and we will draw a line to join these. Okay, next we have got, this is quite clear, we have got an elephant. An elephant. An elephant nose is at the tip of its trunk. Here you can see its trunk. So it's too easy. Here we have got elephant and its trunk. So we are going to join these two. Very good. The next we have is rabbit. Rabbit. Okay. Where is the nose of rabbit? It's too clear now. This? No. Yes, you're right. This is the nose of a rabbit. Okay, so we are going to join these two. Very good. Next we have got, what we have, we have got a wolf here. Okay, a wolf or a dog, you can say. We are going to have a nose of a dog or a wolf here, because this is the special kind of a dog, and we call it German Shepherd. It's close to the wolf. So we are going to join these two. Okay, so here we have joined these. Last but not least, we have got a camel. A camel. Okay, have you seen a camel? Yes, and here we have got camel nose here. Camel nose here. So we are going to join these two pictures like this. Very good. So this page is done. You have joined the nose of different animals and human to their respective pictures over here. Okay, moving on to the next page, we have got another very interesting activity, a tasty treat. Taste some food. How does the food taste? Tick the correct column, pick the correct letter from the food shown below. Alright, dear students, here we have got a table, okay, and here we have got things. We have to taste these things and we will tell that what is the taste of these things, and we are going to write them over here, okay. So what do we have? We have got sweet, we have got sour, we have got bitter, and we have got salty, okay. And what is the letter? We are going to write the letter over here. Okay. So here the things which I can see are, here we have got chips, apple, lemon, tomato, chocolate. Okay. So I have got these things for you. let's do this activity and then you will be able to tell us what is the taste of which food. Okay. Okay, students, what do we have here? We have got all our food items and this is our tasty treat. Okay. So here, as you can see, we have given them the tags A, B, C, D and E. So here we have got few food items and we will tell them what we will tell about their taste. Okay. So first of all, what do I have? I have got chips. So what will you do? You will get a pack of Lay's and you will taste it. Have you got it? Okay, you must have a pack of Lay's and you will eat it one by one. Have you done it? Okay, so what do you think? What is the taste of a food item? What is the taste of Lay's? That is yummy. It's a little bit salty. Next, what we have? The B food item. We have got an apple. We have got an apple. So let's take a bite of this apple. Have you got an apple? Okay, hold it in your hand and take a bite. Yums, this is very nice. Okay, so can you tell me what is the taste of this apple? It's sweet. Is it sweet? Your apple must be sweet because my apple is very sweet and yummy also. So the B food item is apple. The next, what do we have? We have got a lemon. Okay, lemon. So lemon, and we call it lime as well. Okay, so the taste of this lime is what? The taste of this lime, you must have to taste a little bit of it. Okay, or else you will feel it is too much tangy. Okay, so the tangy flavor it has and it is too sour. The taste of the lemon is too sour. So the next food item we have here, D. And what is the D? D is we have ketchup. We love to eat ketchup all the time. Okay, so what is the taste of ketchup? The taste of ketchup is, yes, the taste of ketchup is sour. Okay, sour. It has also a tangy flavor. Next food item, we have our very favorite, very own E food item is chocolate. What do we have? We have chocolate and I have got what? I have got dark chocolate. Okay, what is the taste of dark chocolate? It's not that sweet. It's a little bitter, but maybe you have got your sweet and yummy kind of chocolate. Okay, so dear students, I have got all these food items. As I have told you that you have to taste them at your home. Okay, so take a look. At A we have Lay's, at B we have apple, and at C we have lime, then at D we have tomato, and then we have E chocolate. You have to taste all these things and you will tell me. Okay, now let's move on to the book and we will do our remaining work there. All right students, that was a very yummy treat. Okay, so now you have tasted all these things, it will be easy for you to tell us that what is the taste of which food item. So first of all, as we have tasted the chips, okay, so we are going to write A over here. And what was the taste of the chips? Sweet, sour, bitter or salty? It has got a salty taste. So we are going to tick over here. That's good. Then what we have tasted? B. B was apple. Okay, it was apple. So what was the taste of apple? Sweet, sour, bitter, salty. It was, yes, you are right, it was sweet. That's good. Then we have got C. What is on the C? Lemon. Lemon. So what was the taste of lemon? It was quite tangy. So we have sweet, sour, bitter, salty. We will mention sour. It has got a sour taste. Okay. Next, what we have? We have got tomato ketchup. Yes, yummy. We love tomato ketchup a lot. Okay. So, what is the taste of tomato ketchup? Sweet? No. Sour? Yes, the taste of tomato ketchup is sour. Very good. Next, we have got chocolate. Chocolate. And what is the taste of chocolate? The taste of chocolate. I have got the chocolate which was dark chocolate. And dark chocolate is a little bit bitter. Okay. So, I will take over here. But if your chocolate is what? If it is sweet, okay, it is more sweet, it's a milk chocolate, then what we are going to do, we are going to take this sweet. Alright, so we did this activity very well. Moving on to the next page, what do we have? Alright, dear students, I have got all these things here with me. So, the fourth activity is of smell. Okay, what is the fourth activity? The fourth activity is of smell. So, we use our sense of smell. We have got these different things over here and we have to smell them. Do these objects have an odor? Odor means that they have any smell. Take the correct column for each object. So, here we have got these things with us. We are going to smell them and then we will tell you what is the smell of these things and we are going to take which column. Okay, let's do the activity. Okay, students, so what we have here, we have got an activity of smell. So, I have arranged these things here. Okay, so first of all, what we have here, we have got garlic. Okay, what we have got garlic here. So, you people must have garlic at home as well. Okay, your mothers, they used to cook and they use garlic. So, take a garlic and smell it. Have you smelled it? Do you feel it has got an odor? It is smelling. Stinky kind of smell. Okay, so garlic has an odor. It has got smell. Then next we have got lime. Lime, if you mix lime with water and put a little bit of sugar in it, it becomes a very yummy kind of drink and it's quite refreshing for summer season. Okay, so smell the lime. If you have got lime at home, you can also find it in your kitchen. Okay, you will ask your mom to give you a lime. Now just cut it and smell it. Have you smelled it? Yes, did you feel that the lemon have got a tangy kind of smell? Yes, so lime has got smell. The next we have water. Water, you can easily get water. Okay, just take water in a glass. Have you taken it? Yes, now smell it. Can you feel any smell? No, water doesn't have any smell. It doesn't have any smell and it is odorless. Okay, it doesn't have any odor. Next, what do we have? We have got vinegar. We use vinegar in our like soups and in Chinese dishes to make them a little tangy. Okay, so open the bottle of this vinegar. You can find it easily in your kitchens. Ask your mom. Lots of kitchen things are involved today. So take the vinegar, open the lid of it and smell it. It is also some pungent kind of smell. So vinegar also have smell. Next we have air freshener. Okay, air freshener. We always use air freshener to get some nice smell in our room. So the air freshener also have got very nice smell. Okay, so dear students, all these items that I have presented here, these are easily available at home. So, you must try to smell all these things at home. Now, we will move on to the book and do our activity over there. Alright students, have you done this activity? That was very interesting. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to now fill this column as it is being asked that all these things which we have smelled, do they have an order? Order or orderless? They don't have any order. Okay, so first of all, we have garlic. Yes, garlic has got a very stinky kind of order. So we are going to take over here. But we have got lime. Lime has also got an order and it is a little bit tangy. Okay, so we are going to take water. Does water have an order? No. Water doesn't have any order. It is orderless. So we are going to take under orderless. Next we have got vinegar. Vinegar also have got a very pungent kind of order. Okay. So we are going to take here. Then we have got air freshener. Air fresheners always have got a very pleasant kind of smell. So we are going to take over here. Yes, okay. So this was the last activity of this chapter. Dear students, I am sure that you people must have enjoyed all these activities and this chapter. Alhamdulillah, we did our unit number 2. This was about our senses. Now what you are going to do, that you must have to learn all the questions from your planning in Urdu workbook, and you must have to do all these activities by your own. Okay, you can take help from the parents, but try to solve this by your own so that you can learn the uses of your senses. All right, so that's all from today's lecture. Inshallah, we will do the next chapter in the next lecture. Okay, till then, Allah Hafiz.